Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Built by Ben. This week's episode we will be dealing with the second half of this big wooden frame for this decking. You can see that we've got quite an awkward shape to deal with here. There's only so much thinking you can do with this. It was quite a big job to take on by myself and I probably should have got some help for it, but I didn't have anything available at the time. So with the use of clamps and bits of wood, you'll see that we just managed to keep this perimeter frame stable for long enough for me to just, you know, get some measurements and then start building the frame up. I always feel with this thing you can overthink it. Sometimes it's better to just get in there with some lengths of wood, start putting things in position, getting your measurements and strengthening it all up, and before you know it you're almost complete and you haven't had to think about it too much. So you can see me just squaring it up to the original decking now. That was quite important to me because you don't want that sort of running out with that original decking, especially where the boards go beside the original decking, because you know, you don't want to end up sort of, not too much anyway, but you don't want to end up with like an angled board going into that higher one. You'll see what I mean later in the next episode when we deal with the composite decking. So thank you for all of my recent subscribers, all of my existing subscribers as well. Thanks for all your comments, all of your likes. If you can do me a favour and head over to my Instagram as well, give me a follow on there because I'm trying to build that up. We keep on having peaks and troughs with the YouTube, but I think that's pretty normal. Sometimes one of my videos does really well and other times it flops, but I suppose it's just what people are interested in that week. But yeah, trying to get noticed by some more people. We've got something in the pipeline that might be quite an interesting move for me shortly, so I'll announce that soon over on the Instagram. I'm going to try and keep all of my daily stuff on my Instagram and all of my sort of big videos on YouTube. YouTube shorts are good, but it doesn't seem to react very well to all of my sort of day-to-day stuff, so I'll only be putting the specials on there and then keeping my day-to-day stuff over on Instagram and Facebook. So if you want to follow me on either of them too, head on over. All the links are in my bios, so click on them. And then something new that I'm going to start as well is the people that are making the most noise on my channels will, I'll pick one of them, and they'll be receiving a nice little thing at the end of the month, whether it's a gift voucher or a hoodie or a new tool that I've managed to get my hands on. We'll be doing a little giveaway at the end of each month for the top fan, shall we call it. But yeah, thanks guys, support's really good still. Channel's going upwards and onwards. I think 23 is going to be a good year for the YouTube channel, so I'll carry on pecking away at it. So you can see here we just managed to sort of balance all of that perimeter frame in place while we can get a fix into it. Again, we've gone for 4x2. Although I have used a 6x2 on the very right hand side there because that's almost like a cantilevered platform. It's not fully cantilevered. You'll see later in this video that actually gets strengthened up from the underneath. I'll show you how I did that before the video is out. But here you can just see the difficult bit for me is just building up that perimeter frame. All of the infill is the easy bit, but getting this bit all sitting bright and square with each other, you've just really got to take your time. If anyone needs to know anything that isn't in the video, just let me know in the comments section. I obviously tried to condense these videos down to 15-16 minutes, this one. But it's actually 3 days worth of work, so it's quite hard condensing it down and still keeping the interesting parts in there. But like I said, if you have got anything you need to know, just leave it in the comments section, I'll get back to you. So you'll see this piece here, although that's 4x2, and that's almost like a counter-levered part as well. I didn't feel necessary to put a bit of 6x2 in there because it's so short. But that also gets treated with the rod system that I used in the last episode. By the end of this decking video, you'll see that the decking gets absolutely peppered in these rods. They go everywhere, really, because I like it all to be as strong as possible. And in that counter lever part as well, I also beef the rod system up to an M16 rod instead of the M12, which I put everywhere else, just because I felt like that part needed some extra strength. And when I was finished with it, you could jump up and down as much as you wanted, and that wasn't moving a millimetre. So every part of this decking, although it is 4x2, is supported every metre. So there's not a span longer than 1 metre in the whole of the decking. I did check the span book, and the span book told me to go every 1.7 metres, surprisingly. I was quite shocked by that, but for a C24 4x2 timber, it did only need to be that. So yeah, going down from 1.7 to 1 metre made it as strong as it can be, really. I think anything under 1 metre is overkill. But you can see there, we just managed to put a wall plate into the left hand side there so that we could connect that timber to it. I actually lost a bit of footage where I put the wall plate all the way on the angle there up to the higher part of the decking. There's a few bits of footage I missed on this one because it was over 6 weeks. Sometimes a battery died or a memory card ran out. There's not a lot you can do about that, really. So you can see here the resin's going into the existing floor there. Whoever laid this patio before, and it's probably why I come up with this idea, but whoever laid this patio before, they put about a 200mm concrete slab under this thing, so it's never moving in a million years. If the patio was, you know, really bad, or, you know, it was soft underneath, I probably wouldn't use this system. Because it was so good underneath, that's why I decided to use it. You can see we're just pushing a rod down all the way into that chem fix there, and then winding that top nut all the way up to that washer. And the best thing about this system is that if any of it at all didn't quite sit right, you could just adjust it with them nuts. Because I faced the bow of the timber downwards, you could just keep on winding the nut upwards until the timber sat exactly where you wanted it. And then the weight of this composite decking all sitting down on top of it, you know that the timber's never going to come upwards. So yeah, it's a really good system in my eyes. It's definitely faced some controversy from the American market. Seems to have a lot of comments on the viral video from them guys. They obviously work to a code out there with their deckings, similar to our building control, but we don't deal with them on decking unless the decking is elevated 300mm off of the ground or more. They deal with code wherever they do a decking, so it doesn't matter whether it's on, you know, just over a garden, they still deal with code. So that's obviously why they're such uproar about my little rod system. You can see now we're tackling the stairs. Now this was a bit of a funny one for me. Again, I could have just dug all of them stairs out, broke it all up, got it into the skip, but it was just extra cost. Once we got all that cost together, it's actually surprising how that can mount up, because all of that waste, as soon as you dig it out, it becomes double. So you probably fill in a small skip just with that little step there, and then you've got to, you know, beef up all of your timbers as well. So you're paying a lot more if you do it that way. So this way we come up with a way to, you know, go to the customer's budget and to make it all nice and strong. So again, with this sort of thing, you've just got to chuck some timber at it, really. You can overthink it again. You've just got to keep on just piecing little bits of wood in, seeing where you can make it strong. You can see that bit that I've left long there, because I've obviously got to do a slight little bit of an L shape that goes around the corner. But yeah, it's just thinking ahead, but not overthinking it. That is the key. I used to do that when I was a bit younger, and I would just completely overthink a job, spend most of the day head scratching, get myself in such a tiz about it, and then job would take twice as long, and I'd also make mistakes because I'm stressed out. So now I've learnt to just chill out a little bit, go with the flow of it, and if you do make a mistake, just take it apart and start again. You'll see that we're just going to skip ahead in time again in a little bit. You'll see that what we're up to is just beefing the whole thing up with noggins. I've left that front end floating at the moment. That's just sticking up on some small spacers. But that receives the rod system as well on along that whole front edge. You've always got to think about the direction of your composite boards and where you're going to trap water as well, because obviously we're going to picture frame this one. If you've seen the finished pictures on my Instagram, you'll know that we picture frame this one with a black edge. So you've always got to be thinking of where that black edge is going, the width of the board. And the width of the board then needs to sit on something on the back edge as well, not just on the front edge. And then all of the boards that then come into that black edge have also got a finish on something. So you've always got to have that in mind at this stage. But then when you start, cutting your composite deck in and putting that all together, you have got a chance then to just bang in some extra noggins or some lengths of wood as you need them. So again, you don't need to stress too much at this stage, but just have it in mind. And again there, when you've got a bit like this, I always just put one nail in. You can see, put one nail in the top, and then you can adjust it about with your hammer a little bit, and then get your final nails in. The actual force of the Paslo nail going in will always take the piece of wood down or sideways a little bit. So always have that in mind. I just always offer up that first one just a tiny bit higher than where you need it to finish. And then by the time you pull that trigger on the PAS load, it'll just knock it down a bit. And if it doesn't knock it down far enough, you can always just hammer it down like you saw me do. And here you can see I was just building that little intermediate step, sort of mid left of the picture now. So this part here, although it's quite difficult to film because there's a conservatory to the right of my shoulder there, but I've just built a sort of facade hanging frame there. So that bit of 4x2 that runs all the way across the bottom is screwed into that concrete pad. That's got 120mm screws with spacers behind, and then we've got upright 4x2s, you can see me knocking one in now, that will in turn help support that bit of 6x2 on that floating edge there. So we've got it all as strong as possible, really. And then the final job to do on all of it, once all of the frame was filled in, I bought some 4x2 hangers, metal hangers like you'd see on joists, and I put that on every end that I could get to, just to help that strength. So we're coming towards the end of the actual decking part now, or the frame of the decking at least. If you've enjoyed the video, then please like it, comment on it, and tell a mate about it. Don't forget to get over to my Instagram, give us a follow on there, it'd be really helpful. And hopefully you'll see me next week. We'll start getting some of the composite decking down. I'm showing you how to put that down, or the way I do it anyway. We've got a small little finished sort of picture of it here. I didn't get a good finished picture, but this is all the step all built up with the rods all put in. But yeah, again, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you on the next episode.